your dogs are coming from. If you're focused only on taking the dogs out, but you're not focusing on where the dogs are coming from, it's like, you know, they're saying, like, you have a leaking boat, you're inside the boat, you're just taking out the water, you're not plugging the holes. So the important thing is actually to find where the holes are and plug the holes. If a lot of our holes are coming from dogs that are being born on the streets itself, or a lot of them aren't community dogs, then yes, I would say TNR is the solution for that. But if a lot of our dogs are actually coming from abandoned dogs, would TNR work in that case? Not necessarily, because we are taking it, we're putting it back on the streets, but more dogs are being added that are not yet neutered and being placed on the streets. So we need to really look at the different situations and where dogs are coming from. So that explains this quite a lot. In fact, if you pick any country, dog population dynamics changes over time. So if you pick any country in the world, let's say USA, you think that countries like the America does not have, people assume that they do not have a lot of stray dogs problem. Okay? Stray dogs are on the streets. But actually, what happened in America is they're very efficient at removing the dogs from the streets. It's not that they don't have the dogs on the streets. They're very efficient at removing the dogs from the streets. That's why it seems like there's not much of an issue. They have a big abandonment issue coming from here onto the streets or directly into rehoming centers. So rehoming centers still have a lot of unwanted animals that they are euthanizing at the rate of millions every year. It makes our numbers look very small compared to them. But, you know, the impression is that there's not many roaming dogs. It's different problem, dog population dynamics changes over time. What about Europe, let's say, for example? People think that Europe has solved the problem. But do you think the problem is solved? Not necessarily. They do not have a street dog problem. They do not have a roaming dog problem. Why? Because their RPO, their responsible pet ownership, is good. So even countries like Norway, for example, one of the lowest neutering rates country in the world, because neutering is actually illegal in Norway. They consider it as unethical. It's not necessary for their animals. So they have very low neutering rates. But at the same time, people, when they keep dogs, the dogs come and eat, they know how to confine it. They know how to deal with those dogs. If most other countries don't know how to deal with those dogs. So neutering is still the number one thing to do for the dogs if you have a dog. But because they don't have a street, they don't have a big street animal population, TNR doesn't work there. They don't need to do TNR anymore. What they need to do is they need to do continuous education to get people to understand what it takes to be a responsible pet owner. And right now, I would say this issue is coming up on this side, which is where the breeding of dogs are coming from. Because the demand is there, there's no dogs in the rehoming center. So what they do? What's the problem there? They have a lot of illegal smugglers bringing dogs in. So the dog population dynamic is different in different countries. That is why, no matter which country we are in, this should be a permanent community service for the people. As long as people keep dogs, as long as there is a dog population, there must be an authority that is responsible to manage the dog population. Okay, how much time do we have?
Time's up with me.
Okay, I think that's it. I've got a few more slides, but let's not go through. I would say, if you want to know more information, okay, I work internationally. I work with evidence-based approach. So I don't just simply say because I think it's, you know, it's my experience. I say because evidence show that it works. iCare Coalition is a coalition of all the big international NGOs that funds projects of dog population management all around the world. they come together as a coalition to share their experience in terms of what they have learned. They share their data in terms of what they have collected. They share knowledge in terms of what works. So if you go to that website, you have guidance there that you can download. In fact, in the last couple of weeks, we have just launched short courses. And these short courses is targeted in two audiences: people who do rescue work or work in shelters, and authorities who needs to have a basic understanding of dog population management. So go there, it's free for to do this short course and basically learn about it. So that's my presentation.
Thank you so much, Dr. Natasha. That's a very informative journey she has given us. Thank you so much from all of us. Okay, we will come to our last part where Dr. Natasha is the moderator for a dialogue between the presenters, the advocates who spoke today, and also our special guest with us today. Right? Dr. Natasha, take it away.
Yeah, thank you. So far, I think let's start with